This is Capital One Tournament Central.
Wayne Selden Jr., the Jayhawks' second leading scorer, getting ready for tonight's Sweet 16 matchup with Maryland. Time now for Just Ask, brought to you by Alexa-enabled Amazon Echo. Check this out. The Kansas football team setting up a little basketball court on the field and shooting hoops in support of the Kansas Jayhawks.
That's nice camaraderie.
It is.
Maybe that's the reason they suck at football. They play basketball to a bunch of.
Come on. He just cannot help himself.
Wait, come on, man.
You just can't help yourself.
Come on.
We asked Kenny to police his area, and we asked you to police yourself.
He doesn't know how to police himself.
I'm just asking, man.
You know what I'm saying?
That's why they need to work on football skills.
We've seen a couple of games that haven't been very close this evening. Maryland, Kansas, going to be anywhere near each other?
I think this will be a little more snug. I really do, because Maryland has the ability to match up with Kansas extremely well. Inside-outside balance, excellent guard play. And they've actually gotten some contributions from the bench. DeMonte Dodd, Nickens has started to make shots. I really think this will be the most resistance Kansas has faced in a long time. They've won 16 straight, and not many speed bumps along the way. I think they're going to run into a bit of a boulder here tonight. I still think Kansas prevails, but it won't be easy.
Yeah, I want to see Kansas when all of a sudden there's a log jam and there's a lot of traffic. See if you can get through this, navigate yourself through it. And my instinct is telling me that this is the upset tonight. Before the tournament, I thought Maryland would be a sleeper team, not knowing where everyone would be seated at that time. And this is a team that, you know, they still have the talent, Chuck, to be a top five team in college basketball. They just haven't done it and proved it.
Are you picking Maryland or not?
I just did. I just said, okay. This is the night. This is the upset.
Just say it. I'm going with Maryland.
He did. He said
it. Okay. If you listen to me sometime, you might even hear it.
That's never going to happen.
You might learn something.
Listen, you got two fantastic backcourts. Mm-hmm. I think they will cancel each other out. Two fantastic backcourts. But the difference to me is going to be between Diamond Stone and Perry Ellis. I'm going to go with Ellis because I think you can slow Stone down by playing the zone at particular times. But to me, Ellis in the open court is going to be the difference in the game. I'm going with Kansas.
And by the way, the winner of that game gets Villanova. We'll have more Capital One Tournament Central after this. Welcome back, everyone, for more NCAA tournament news, highlights, analysis. Tune in to the Infinity NCAA tip-off pregame tomorrow on TBS at 6 p.m. Eastern Time. Coming up, Maryland and Kansas, the basketball team, not the football team. A date with Villanova awaits the winner. We'll see you at halftime. Enjoy the game, everyone.
Coverage of the NCAA men's basketball tournament is sponsored by Southwest. Audi. And by AT&T.
Let's go, Karen. Here we go. Let's go, Hawks. Come on, KU.
It's game two in Louisville, the South Regional semifinal matchup between the five-seed Maryland and the number one overall seed of this tournament, the Kansas Jayhawks, with the winner to face Villanova on Saturday night here in Louisville for the right to go to Houston and the Final Four. Friends, welcome back. Chip Nance along with Grant, Billy, and Tracy. You've got now in a Kansas team, one that comes in here looking like it's hitting on all cylinders. We were there last week to see it in Des Moines.
And we were impressed by this Kansas team. They are capable of winning it all, but they must respect and fear the turtle, and in particular, Metal Trimble.
But it's an old ACC thought.
Yeah.
There.
Yeah.
Mello, much like our personalities, it's big how he plays. He's got to be patient, intelligent. I think pass up the threes, he'll be defended well by Kansas.
Well, Tracy has got an update on one of the key players in this game, Frank Mason III.
That's right, Frank Mason III, a big key to containing Melo Trimble, but he comes in not 100% healthy. He's dealing with a sore left foot and a hip injury. I spoke with head coach Bill Self in practice yesterday. He said he did have some tightness, but doesn't think it will affect him. He said he needs to play well against one of the best guards in the nation. One other note, reserve Brandon Green out for the game with a nagging back injury.
Well, that has been off and on all season. It gives him 6 points a game, but not expected to play here tonight. Brandon Green, so that's breaking news. Melo Trimble
the sophomore, the man who is the leader of the Terrapins. So you see the starters, and Seldon having good showings in the first two rounds of this tournament, including 22 against UConn in their second round victory. Bill Self, once again, the Big 12 Coach of the Year. That's the fifth time in his 13 years at Kansas he's won Coach of the Year honors. And meanwhile, how about this for a story? Mark Turgeon, fifth year at Maryland, former point guard at Kansas. He was a starting point guard his junior year for a Kansas team that made it to the Final Four 30 years ago. Guys, I expect this one's going to be fun to watch.
I would agree. We all agree how good Kansas looked. You know, Maryland's got pieces. Can they put it together? Well, they play solid.
Well, they played well here thus far in the tournament, but they need a superior effort here against this Kansas ball club.
Kansas 32-4 on the year, having won 16 straight, hasn't lost in 2 months. Maryland 27-8, defeated South Dakota State and Hawaii to make it to the Sweet 16. And the tap goes to the Jayhawks.
Jim Nance, Grant Hill, right now the Terrapins.
All right, Billy Raftery, here we go with Ellis.
You know Kansas loves to go to Ellis on that first play. Carter defended that spin move.
Yeah, nice belly bump to get him wider.
It's Trimble.
Nice catch.
Lehman.
This matchup here is going to be crucial.
And that's last touch by Kansas.
Seldon having a wonderful tournament. Lehman picking it up, shooting the ball well. Has a little bit of size on Seldon, can get the shot off against him. But that matchup right there will be fun to watch.
Anxious to see how Maryland shoots it. It's Suleiman. Hits the three. Now they made only one. In the victory over Hawaii, they were 1 out of 18 from 3, including misfiring on the first 15 from out there. They hit their first tonight. That's Graham. And a foul on the floor called on Maryland.
Grant, this is a great set play. Pin down the ability of Suleiman. I love the way he puts it on the deck. If he can complement it with that deep one, they'll be applauding him.
And how about after they couldn't buy one last week?
Amazing.
Law of averages, you're a good shooting team, they're bound to go in.
Boy, that's spoken like a guy who didn't mind jacking them up.
Hey, coach, you miss every shot you don't take.
That whistle was on Carter.
Trying to defend on the dribble. And Carter is the guy that Bill Self is concerned about on the pick and pop at the other end.
They changed it to Trimble. Trimble, it's a quick one. That's Ellis, and he works the body. He works the blocks incredibly well.
He's got a great mid-range game to complement it too, Jim.
Now they get it to Carter. Doubled up quickly.
Nice drag dribble kick.
Lehman, he shoots the three from the corner, and it's long. Carter, though, maintains it for Maryland.
And to Grant's point, Lehman got that open look as he's got a few inches.
They say that ball was saved. Ellis to Mason.
Pretty.
And Lehman has Ellis on his back. It's going to go against the Kansas senior.
During the Sweet 16, it's all about heart and hustle. And Graham, great effort, but the ball might have gone out of bounds.
Sure looked like it hit the end line. That's why I hesitated on that one.
I think Don Daly was sort of blocked out when Seldon ran by him, but what an adjustment at the rim by Mason. Did everything but finish it.
And Kansas opting to put Graham on Trimble. His size may be giving him some problems. You got to keep Trimble, though, out of the paint. Does so much for this Maryland offense.
Suleiman to Trimble. Lowe's pass, puts it up short. Tapped by Carr. Back to Trimble. They've got a couple of offensive rebounds. Trimble gets the floater to go.
He has not been making that floater, and that's his mainstay go-to in that lane.
Mason. Back out with it. Seldon. Payne. Ellis. Jumper. Yes.
Fuck it. This kid steps out. Great understanding of the game. And makes himself available. Distance from his defender.
He's got the first two buckets for the Jayhawks.
Yeah, ice one side.
Suleiman to Carter. a former Georgia Tech player. It's a shot, no whistle, thought there might be one. Comes out with it, it's Selden to Mason.
And what a great give on time. Give that run out, the ability to just catch it, finish. Now they've been switching defenders. Mason's now got Tremble. I like that little yo-yo effect, keep them fresh.
And they're interchangeable on defense with their perimeter defenders here.
Carter, he'll launch the three.
This is where they're dangerous, Coach. In the transition, getting easy baskets, so unselfish.
Ellis, that's a three, and it's long.
And a great balance by the Terps. And a big early drag screen, pick and pop, big concern. Carter's got a nice hesitation.
Left hand is Tremble.
Big time delivery, little hesitation, blow-by.
Tremble is on his game early.
He is, you know, we saw him 2 weeks ago in the Big Ten, and he couldn't turn that corner, wasn't finishing with confidence, but the rest, I think, has helped him out. He's looking great thus far early.
Mason tries to do basically the same thing at this end. Put back, no good for Lucas, and this time, yes.
Yeah, he's a guy that's really solidified this starting team. Terrific rebounder, excellent defender. Carves out big area on the offensive end.
Strong performances in both games last week.
Absolutely. Doesn't need the ball.
Tremble with a three. And it's Selden pulling it down for Kansas.
Look at this strength.
Tapped up, and that's Lucas making contact from behind.
Pretty strong maneuver to the rim. And right here, that hesitation. And look at this high little kiss off the forehead.
And Coach Maryland, sometimes they're not great rebounding, and Lucas, one of the best offensive rebounders, giving a Moses Malone type effort there on that possession.
They're going to sit these guys, get a little extra time because the next whistle will bring the teams to the benches. So Lucas and Ellis both buying a little extra time in the early action.
Are you suggesting Moses missed shots or getting an offensive rebound?
I never said that.
He did, I think, on occasion.
Carter backing him in, turn around, no go. And that's Bragg into the game, along with Traylor for Kansas.
And what kind of luxury, Jim, Kansas, to be able to sub and bring in two quality bigs. Stone and, of course, Carter. They got to play the whole game for Maryland.
Here's Traylor, not a shooter.
Pick and pop, empty side, Jim.
Tremble. He blows past Traylor. There's Stone trying to fly in. And that's going to go against Kansas's Traylor. So, good, intense action at the start of this Sweet 16 game. Kansas, the one, is up one at the first break. We have LG behind the stats. Maryland 2-3 all time against one seeds. The last time Maryland beat a one seed, Maryland was also a one seed. That was at the Final Four national semifinals in Atlanta 0-2. Beat them 97-88. It's the most points any team's ever scored against a Kansas team in NCAA tournament history.
And Jim Tremble always has his eyes up, surveying the landscape, and that little hesitation getting to the basket, nice floater. Tremble has to be big for Maryland to have a chance against the mighty Jayhawks.
And he has that little burst we didn't see at the Big Ten tournament in Indianapolis.
Absolutely.
This entire team at the end of the season, season.
Coaching staff felt they really needed the rest.
Carter with the hook. Mason mixing it up with Diamond Stone, and the tap comes over to Graham.
And you haven't called Stone's name out. He needs some touches, you know?
You got to go to the big fella.
Show and recover.
Here's Mason.
Bragg, nice.
He's up to Bragg, and that's Carter. Says, no, sir.
Great reaction by Carter. Terrific little pass. Nice dive to the rim, and just a reaction here. Carter's struggling on the offensive end. You got to contribute somewhere, big fella.
Demonte Dodd has come in for Maryland. And Stone comes out. Here's Selden.
Nice shot by Lehman.
And they say that's last touched doesn't matter. The shot clock expired anyway.
And that was just a phenomenal defensive possession there for Maryland, helping each other, making the extra effort. And looked like Lehman came over.
Nice play.
Yeah, and length, 6'9".
And Jim, like all coaches, he's talking to Frank Mason, Bill. You get it going quicker.
Stott having a hard time with his first touch. Both teams have missed the last four shots. Suleiman able to hit the jumper.
Nice in and out.
Yeah.
Created a little distance. Mid-range game is still in effect.
He's hit his first two, a three, and a two-point shot. Traver. Bragg keeps it. He's blocked. Go back outside. Selden, top of the key. And one hop rebound, Suleiman. Dribble, stutter step move, he's gonna pop it.
I like that though, Jim. Instead of settling for the three, get his confidence going.
Kansas, meanwhile, with this end, has missed its last seven from the field.
And Merlin's defense has been suffocating too. Pushing guys off the block, forcing tough shots like that.
Yeah, Brad. Way short with the jumper. Suleiman loads it up. And he hits a three. And he's off to a hot beginning here, hitting his first three shots.
And Jim, against Iowa, when Maryland went on a run there in that second half, Suleiman made big plays. The experience has been big for this Terps team.
And Maryland takes it away with Lehman.
Too deep, and Mason's hobbling. He's not running well. Nice cross.
Trimble.
And nobody dove. You got to dive. He's looking for somebody to cut to the rim.
Kansas last week with wins over Austin Peay in Connecticut. Never trailed by more than three at any point the first two rounds. Down four here in the opening minutes.
And Maryland trying to run their sets. Kansas a pretty good set. Took away that little flex screen.
Three to shoot.
Tough shot.
Trimble never touched the rim. Bragg.
And Kansas looks out of sorts here on offense. He's not getting into any rhythm.
Graham. With a short trip for the Jayhawks.
There's a frustration shot right there.
You know, both teams are tired right now, Jim. You can see it. Everybody standing up straight, holding hips, Selden on the side. They got a bunch of subs getting ready to come in.
Yeah, three on each side about to enter.
I wouldn't take Suleiman out the way he's playing.
Suleiman. Here's Carter with two to shoot.
Well, the ability to make some shots certainly loosens up the interior defense. But that little hand move with the bounce, a little nylon. He is looking to get back to Texas. He keeps playing like that. The Terps are going to be on board with him. Solid performance early.
Got a foul on Traylor going to the break. Maryland up four. Who delivered the Buick expectation-shattering performance of the day? Tune in to Inside March Madness presented by Buick and find out. That was the second foul on Traylor. Stone is back on the floor for Maryland. Has not been really involved in much of the action at the start. Good-looking 6'11 freshman out of Milwaukee. Here he is, though. Short with the shot. Defended by Lucas. Dodd saves it for the Terrapins.
Yeah, nice job. Hustling, scrambling. Brantley on the floor now. These are two handlers. I'd still go to Stone. He is a tough out inside.
It's Trimble. He hits the shot. Two-point jumper.
Three for eight. I like his middle game versus settling deep. And now on the floor, you've got Ellis. It'll be a little more organized for Kansas.
Kansas has not scored in 5 minutes, missing its last nine shots.
And McCulloch on the floor for that reason, too, Jim. His ability to ring the bell.
Here he is, number 10. He had 23 in the opening round win against Austin Peay. Ellis.
He knows how to get the attention.
Yes, he does. So Trimble has made some shots. This one just inside the three-point arc.
And you talk about his confidence, but also not settling. Putting the defense, getting them to retreat on their heels, and knocking down that easy mid-range jump shot. Trimble now, he struggled, went through some things the end of the regular season. He's playing great basketball now for his ball club.
And Tracy, what do you hear over on the sideline?
Well, you guys are talking about Melo Tremble and how he struggled down the stretch. He told us yesterday a lot had to do with the hamstring injury he suffered at Rutgers in early January. He said he thought he could just play through it, but realized that wasn't the case. He said he had to get some time off. He had to rest. He had to get in the ice tubs and stretch it out. That allowed him to get healthy, and now he feels like he's his old self again.
And they forced the turnover, trying to get the inbounds pass to Brantley. And that was Graham, who really made the play there for Kansas. And, you know, to Tracy's point here, this is a team that definitely was fatigued, losing 4 out of 6 games at one time late in the year. They needed some rest, and they got it really here in the recent weeks.
They really have. They've only played 4 games in the last 18 days, so they feel refreshed and recharged and look great as Ellis with a tremendous finish.
That would refresh you, that kind of delivery.
Well, it's given guys like Tremble a chance to get healthier.
Now, you know, he had the hamstring the year before, too, they said. So he's played through it. You guys both mentioned he's spry today.
That basket by Ellis, the dunk, breaks a 5.5-minute drought from the field for the Jayhawks.
Nice give.
Tremble gives it to Stone. Ellis is on it.
Gets around him. The freshman able to get away from Ellis, the senior.
Well, he is a tower of strength and footwork. Smooth delivery. A circle to a post up.
We'll see if he can dish it back. Nope. It comes up short with Brantley there to take it. The 5'11 guard able to come inside. Pull away the rebound. Sets up the jumper from the corner. No for Nickens.
They're going the other way. I don't know if they get Stone or not. But, you go to Stone, he makes a great move. You settle for a deep jump shot. You got to get it over. How about this drive, draw, and a little handoff. Ellis with the send it in.
And Stone, you talk about talent, spinning on the baseline. Nice dunk move. But, yeah, Stone, I think you got to continue to go and keep him engaged on the offensive end.
Lehman comes back. Suleiman after a rest. Carter also. That was the first on Stone. He was whistled for that.
Turgeon had was the rebounding. He said this team's usually a better rebounding team. They've been struggling, particularly on long ones, which usually lead to runouts.
Famous.
Able to take it away. Got there before Seldon. Oh. And takes it down.
Lehman swings on the rim.
They're going to call for a technical. He felt the presence of Seldon in the area, and he's going to argue he was trying to protect himself from injury.
And, you know, I thought he actually double dribbled too at half court. They just see if he picks this up and then re-dribbles. See? That's a discontinue.
But what about this call?
I'll tell you what, for someone who's...
Tell me if I'm right or wrong.
Yeah, it might have been a double dribble. I agree with you on that. I don't agree on this. I don't agree on this tech. When you go up with two hands, you can easily... If he lets go, he's going to fall on the ground. So he has to protect himself. And that's why he maybe hung on the rim a little longer.
Of the three of us, I think you're more of an authority on that.
Career opportunities.
It is not a foul, though. It's a book technical.
Well, maybe, too, the officials thought he didn't have possession and he was going after it. But I think he did. I think it was a double dribble. They missed it.
He was out in front of them, in fairness, too.
Vitalis taking it quickly to the hole.
He just calms his team. When he's out there on the floor, Kansas is better. Always makes the timely play for the Jayhawks.
He's got 10 of their 14.
He can get it going off the bounce, too, this kid. I love when he asserts himself like that. Good player. Go after it.
Call on Seldon. Watch live games on your computer, phone, tablet, or streaming devices with NCAA March Madness Live. Watch now at ncaa.com/March Madness or download the app today. It's the first on Seldon. Mason, again, not 100%, returns to action. Inbound Carter looking for help.
Nice job defensively. Go for 33. Tell him you love him. There you go.
There he is from Lehman.
And they heard you, coach.
Well, Lehman is clever, too. He kept that vision, bounced it, and Stone moving quickly to that 10.
Stone with four now, and the Terrapins lead by six.
Makai Luke. The basket counts.
And you talked about the big fella, Lehman. A little romance in the Stone, finding him down low.
Goodness, I love the Makai Luke. When you can shoot the ball like this kid, you can get to the rim, get an opportunity for an old-fashioned three-point play.
And you see his career-high 23 against Austin Peay in 24 minutes of action. Trimble on the floor now after a brief break. Makai Luke, before that 23-point outbreak, had only 8 points in his five previous games. And then he was impressive in the win against the Governors.
And Jim, when we talked to the Kansas players, they weren't surprised by his performance. They've seen that from him in practice and were encouraged and knew that they're going to need him at some point in this tournament. Run.
Well, he had overcome coaching of Mike Fratello. It took him a while.
Yeah, for the Ukrainian national team. Suleiman. He is fouled shooting three by Makai Luke.
And Coach Fratello would not be happy with that defensive play. That's not fouling his, a three-point shooter.
Not his kind of closeout. You're right. Just that skip out. Look at this, reaching down that little quail. You know when the wrist is detected.
And I think that was a two-pointer. Suleiman's foot was on the line.
So they're checking it. You're right.
Yeah, they're over. Had a quick look at it. And definitely it's a two. So they've adjusted. And Suleiman.
You know, Jim, we had time with him yesterday. I was impressed.
No question.
Graduating.
He graduated actually in August from Duke. And, of course, transferred here. And he's going to go through the commencement exercise at Duke in May.
And that's what impressed me the most. You know, not the best of circumstances when you leave. And no one's really been told or heard what the specifics are. But he's proud of that university, and you know, walking tells me a lot about his character.
And he's proud of what he's done. He's come to Maryland. He's rebuilt his game, his image, and his confidence. And he's been big for this ball club this season.
He gets them both, and Suleiman now with 10.
Kansas got to get a little smoother on this offensive end. Usually involves something with Ellis, whether it's a ball screen, a little flare here to a double.
Mason back around Suleiman, back around pass. Isaiah's last touched by the Terrapins.
Really a nice set there. A little fade screen and a double on the foul line, but you can see the preparation by the Terps. Excellent.
This is the best I've seen Maryland in maybe the last couple months. They just defensively, offensively, execution. And
Seldon turns around and pops the three over Lehman.
And Seldon bails out the Jayhawks on that play.
They got Dodd now in the post as Stone gets a breather.
I like that going under when you clock like that. This time over in the show. They got Carter.
Carter's first. These two coaches are connected. They both served under Larry Brown of Kansas. And they're battling here tonight in a good one in Louisville. Choose your favorite player on the court. Or for your taste with Coca-Cola and the NCAA tournament. Jim Nance with Grant Hill, Bill Raftery, Tracy Wolfson here at the South Regional Semifinals. I want to remind you that Duke and Oregon are over on TBS getting started now as Ellis makes another nifty move, up his total to 12 for the game.
He's so smart and intelligent. What a call out of the timeout. Ball screen, empty side, open up, good nice back cut.
Suleiman able to finish it off.
And that's what makes it so tough, because Carter, you got to play him. He can make the three, plenty of room to make that play.
And to your point, Jim, during the timeout, Kansas, it feels like they should be down by double digits, and they're only a three-point game as Ellis gets his shot blocked.
Terrapins have returned the starting five to the floor. This Carter hasn't had much offensively, got a lot of rebounds in this game so far with this move from the inside. I love his first bucket.
And I love the patience down there. Take your time, get into the paint, get wet. Decide what you want. Nice hook shot.
2 points to go along with five rebounds. Two on the offensive end.
I like that, Kent. Wait, you mean the deep end?
No, it's just wet in the paint.
I know. Graham. Same play there. Ooh, they had him in the corner, Ellis. Nobody covered him. Duck in, Lucas.
Lucas, left hand, and soft touch.
It wasn't pretty, but effective.
Lucas seems to be getting better every game.
Yeah, he is. He really understands his role, his limitations, and his upside. Great defender. He's got the big guy.
Trimble comes off a pick. Elects to give it up. Suleiman.
Nice pass.
Carter, he missed the dunk.
Great. Fine.
Mason taking off. Lehman.
How about Stone?
Put back Seldon.
Now you got to come up with that. When a guy makes an effort like that, the other red shirts have to mount an effort. Seize the deal.
Terrapin lead is down to one.
It's Stone to the box.
It's Trimble to the corner to Lehman. Got the look he wanted. Graham pulls it down.
Boy, what energy he plays with.
He's blocked by Stone.
Oh, no.
Oh, they got a whistle here.
No.
Oh, I don't know about that,
Let
coach.
Him play.
It's on Stone, his second.
Oh. I'm going to change his name to Diamond Mountain. Goodness, he's a big, solid kid. And his reaction, this is a shame. That's a good block. There's always going to be body contact, but that's part of basketball. Mm. Pretty good effort. How about him running the floor earlier?
That previous
number two,
play.
Number two.
Yeah,
number
that's two. The key thing.
Mm. But that previous effort there, running the court.
Oh, big time.
Stone doing it on both ends of the court.
Devonte Graham. One more coming.
And it appears on this play that Trimble got elbowed in the face as Graham was turning the corner. I don't know if that was on purpose or.
I think it's just basketball, don't
you? Just basketball, yes, indeed.
Trying to get your arm down, they're going to take a look at it.
When you're playing, you're not thinking about that as you're making a move to the basket. You're thinking about Diamond Mountain.
Hey, Jim, do you remember talking to Trimble about using his head and throwing it up when he drives? He said he's been doing it his whole life.
Well, it's interesting. They're going to go in between the free throws and go check out this. Because I saw before Graham took the first attempt that Suleiman was over there explaining what had happened, showing, gesturing to the officials of what he had seen with his teammate getting hit in the face.
I think it's a play on. If anything, they might do the flagrant one, but I don't think it was malicious. They're just trying to get your, you've got to ward off when you're dribbling with the offhand and arm.
Well, it looked like Graham didn't really have great control of the ball, was trying to turn the corner, and I think it was inadvertent. Obviously, when you watch it in slow motion, it looks a certain way, but at full speed, Graham's just trying to get by and get to the basket. And
they're going to play on.
Trimble does a good job of selling it, too.
See, if these refs have taken the subway in New York, it'll be a play on. That's just a brush.
That's everyday contact.
Yeah, exactly. And that's, I think, just protecting them. You know. They're going to. Good. It looks like they're going to play on here, though. Now, normally they'll come over and explain it to us. But I don't think these three fellas cared about Grant.
I don't think they like your tie tonight, Coach.
No call. All right.
No, no
I
call.
Like it.
Nah, so one more for Graham, who was the Big 12 tournament most outstanding player, including 27 against West Virginia in the Big 12 championship game.
And they win everything they're in. Amazing. There's Maui.
World, how about the World University
game? World University, Big 12, regular season tournament.
Last summer, this team competed in South Korea, played 8 games in 10 days. Trimble, front of the rim. Won the gold over there. Went 8-0 in the 10 days. Last 6 points have gone to Kansas, which has taken the lead now at 27-26. Trailer.
Pretty solid D.
left without the basketball.
Trying to do a little too much. That's not really his game.
Watch Masters Live on CBSSports.com. Exclusive video of what's happening at Amen Corner. Action at 15 and 16. Featured groups, highlights, and analysis. Watch live on CBSSports.com and Masters.com. Of course, full coverage on CBS. Late night highlights Thursday, Friday, and over the weekend on CBS. So,
offense again. Carter, any motion, they're going to call it.
Both calls against Carter have come in the exact same situation. And they called this down at the other end off trailer, but it might have been off the foot of Carter at that end. Off his foot.
My apologies.
Second foul, though, on Carter. So they've got some concern there with Carter's two and two on Stone.
They've all been illegal screens by Carter. The officials have been consistent with making that call.
Nice slip.
Traylor, his third attempt of the game, and he hits the jumper.
I'm going to step it outside, knocking it down 54%, usually more around the rim. Well, they have great rotation up front. And this is the end. I think they're most impressive with their subs. You give away.
Going to be on Bragg. It's going to be a one-on-one for Trimble, who's been exceptional at the free throw line in this tournament.
Yeah, nice little dribble drive. Collapses the defense. Sets it all up for a little kickback. Get those puppies organized. Number 31. Drilling it. And boy, does that help.
You know what yesterday was? It was National Puppy Day.
Oh.
I thought you would know that. I'm not making this up. National Puppy Day. See the influence you have, Raph.
David, they honor me, huh?
1-1. Oh, Trimble had been 22 of 23 through the first two rounds of the tournament at the line.
Well, you must have been busy digging that one up all day.
Oh, no, it was a big day. A lot of us celebrated that all day long.
Nice trail. Counter.
They blocked a few shots, haven't they? Lehman looking. Survey.
It always comes back to Trimble, doesn't it? When they need it or in doubt.
Lehman.
Pretty look.
Back around. Dodd able to get it. Squeeze through a couple defenders.
And that was all made by Lehman right there. Not only a shooter, but putting on the floor and being a facilitator.
There's basket by the Terrapins in over 3 minutes.
Little weave and a run out.
Mason looking for the whistle.
And I like that non-call too. He searched the body.
Lehman coming up with a number of loose balls tonight.
And Mason really late getting back. Oof, he's been getting whacked.
Trimble with a swish. And the lead's back to Maryland.
They are playing solid, complimented by shot making.
And Trimble is feeling good. It's a little step back. Maryland up one here in Louisville.
Timeout, Kansas.
Coverage of the NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament is sponsored by Amazon Echo. Enterprise Rent-A-Car. And by Buick.
Yeah, Tracy got her own bat there from the Louisville Slugger Museum and Factory. Hey, got one too.
Did I have one there? I didn't notice.
There you see the game summary to this point. Kansas has not hit a three to this point. 0 for 3.
They've done a great job getting it inside. 12 field goals, 9 of which have come inside.
Seldon.
Boy, they could use him to light up at that mid-range one. That one didn't go down.
I wonder if Lehman's length is giving him trouble on those jump shots.
Nice hesitation again.
Lehman into the lane and able to put it up and in.
Jimmy's got great extension. I'd love to see him go to the rim more. Nice style now, step.
That looked more like the Kansas team you saw last week right
there. The speed, pushing it up and down.
Exactly.
They have not been doing that.
That was poor transition defense. Lehman goes to the basket. Somebody's got to help with the court balance. Seldon takes advantage in transition.
Sounds like you played for a defensive-minded coach somewhere along the line.
I don't know why I couldn't play defense.
Tchaikovsky is on the floor right now, number 15 for Maryland.
He can do some damage inside. He's a nice player.
7'1", sophomore out of Slovakia. 5 to shoot. Coming up out of the break. It'll be Maryland ball. Get 5 to shoot. Look at the move by Lehman over Ellis.
Mr. Lehman gets up high. Nice touch and finishes at the basket. Helping his Maryland Terps team here against a pretty good Kansas ball club.
Not a real understanding of getting it inside. They run set plays on the out of bounds. A little flex cut to the box. Little dump down. Seldom. And the Ellis wisely in the right spot.
Well, I'll tell you what, Mr. Suleiman has been heroic in the first half for Maryland. From downtown, back cuts, finishing at the basket. The man from Straight Jesuit Prep in Houston wants to go back to the Final Four.
3 to shoot. And that's going to go out of bounds. It'll go to Kansas with 2 minutes to go. He'd love to get back to the Final Four in his hometown at NRG Stadium, which will be filled with over 70,000 strong next week, guys.
And that's your hometown too, Jim.
And, you know, I absolutely am proud to claim it. No question. Proud of my University of Houston ties.
You haven't moved around much.
Yeah.
Well, really nice denial. 5 cent Chekovsky.
Here's Graham. Run to the rim. Pulled down by Lehman.
Now this is a, well, they got a good size lineup. I see Dodd on the floor too. And they can play small, go either way.
Trying to go these last couple of minutes with Stone protecting him, keeping him out. Carter both with 2 fouls.
I think this lineup needs Lehman to do something with Suleiman.
There he is. Suleiman with Ellis on him.
Tough shot again.
Way short. Lucas.
Kansas tightening the screws right now on the defensive end. Nice cross. Charge.
Mason will call Ellis. Ball on the floor. All the starters for Kansas out there. Going against Kansas, again, the Maryland team right now with a couple of subs. It's Graham, under a minute to go. Seldon from the corner, and there's a three.
How about that, getting back on the floor in the right spot.
First three of the night for the Jayhawks. Kansas goes back up by two. Coming up, AT&T at the half, first half analysis and an update on Duke and Oregon battling right now out in Anaheim. And the latest NCAA tournament news on the AT&T at the half. Seldon makes the first three of the evening for Kansas.
And the big thing there is he hunted his shot. He didn't stay in the distance, ran that baseline, little handoff. The knockdown by Big Wayne Jr.
They bring Stone and Carter back out for these final seconds of the first half, and it's going to stay at this end.
Jim, that's interesting. You bring Stone in, why not use him? A dribbling drive could have been a turnover. A little bit of a gamble, right? Give him a touch.
It looked like Maryland cleared the whole side and allowed Trimble to go one-on-one. Just couldn't finish against Mason.
That's going to be on Mason. His first.
One-on-one here is, he can really attract. I think he averaged 7 free throws a game last year. Now he's down to 5, which tells you a little bit, right?
Well, it does, but as of late, he's getting to the line. Yeah. He was 13 for 14 in the last game, the second round against Iowa. So he's managed to get that ability back to draw fouls.
It's a one-on-one. This time able to hit the front end.
Didn't he lead all of college basketball last year with the most free throw attempts?
I'm not sure, but I'm sure you've read it someplace, right?
I've read a lot this week.
Hey, Jimmy's got a famous high school coach's name, right?
Yeah, Joe Wooten, son of the legendary Morgan Wooten out of DeMatha High School. He's coached by his son, Joe. Hits the 2 free throws, 38 seconds to go. Great ball game to this point, tied at 34. Mason, who hasn't been himself, 1 out of 6 from the field.
Physically, I don't think he's right there.
Here's the last man. The basket by Lucas.
A nice little setup. Little brush, little dive.
Let's see how Trimble runs the offense here. The final 10 seconds.
Chekovsky, I think, will come out, or one of the bigs. He's going 1-4.
Taking on Graham.
and not a good play. I don't like 1-4. Everybody knows you are the guy unless you pop up on the wings and you get a kick. This is just ready-made for the defense. Look how early Ellis set up. That.
And Ellis always in the right position, way outside of the restricted zone. And not a good play there for Mello Trimble.
And even worse for Maryland, and the process picks up his second. So 2.7 seconds to go. Bench warning just issued against the Terrapins. And Kansas will try to go length of the court here.
A lot can happen in 2 seconds, Coach.
I might say if LeBron were running 1-4, I might like it.
Graham.
Look at this another chance.
Short with a shot.
Oh, great preparation.
Good look, didn't he? Could have put the Terrapins up one at the intermission. You got three Terrapins with two fouls in Stone, Carter, and Trimble. Very exciting first half with Kansas going to the locker room leading at 36-34. Tracy's with Bill Self. Let's go over to Tracy now.
Thanks a lot. And Coach, Selden the three and then Lucas the bucket there. What did you see from your team down the stretch here that you didn't see early on in this game?
Well, I thought we played hard. I thought both teams played extremely hard. We didn't rebound the ball early on, but our defense got a little bit better. But still, we can play. We can run a lot better offense. We're pretty impatient right now.
How do you adjust on Suleiman and Trimble right now, combined shooting 22 points?
Well, we got to keep them off the free throw line. They're going to make some baskets. We know that. But keep them off the free throw line and pay attention to the scouting report.
Thanks a lot, Jim.
There were 7 lead changes in that first half. It's a 2-point Jayhawks lead at the intermission. And again, we remind you that Duke and Oregon are playing right now on TBS. But AT&T at the half is coming up here on CBS. After these messages, you're watching the NCAA Men's Basketball Championship.
AT&T at the half is presented by AT&T, mobilizing your world.
Welcome back to New York for AT&T at the half. Kansas and Maryland in a close one, tightest game of the night. Jayhawks up at halftime, 36-34. Greg Gumbel along with Clark, Kenny, and Chuck. Let's talk about what you saw in the first half, Kenny.
Well, you know, I think overall that this is a interesting game, you know, in terms of I think Maryland has the pace that they want. They're able to get to the areas of the floor they want. And so my vision is a little bit different. Kenny vision. So straight to the point right here. And I think overall is the Maryland guards are really good at turning the corner, because once they turn the corner, they want to put pressure on you and get you on your heels. And this is what we've been saying about playing downhill. We want to do it again. Trimble gets it. He says, after Suleiman, you tried it? Well, I'm going to try it. I'm getting in the paint. If I get my feet in the paint, it's going to open up the game for me. So I get my feet in the paint. We missed a shot, but then all of a sudden, I'm still in the paint. I'm going to just drive it again, get an easy basket. So now I got you backing up. I'm playing downhill again. Again, turn that corner. Get into the paint. Make Perry Ellis come out. And if you do, then they believe you're going to take this jump shot. But no, I'm getting my feet in the paint early on. So early part of the game. Then Suleiman says, I got you now. You think as a defender you're going to switch and going to cut this down. You think I'm going to the paint? You're too big, too slow. I rise up, jump shot. So for me, the Maryland guards have got the game where they want it to go. They're in position. And you have to do it for 40 minutes. So 40 minutes right where you want to be, one possession game.
All right, that's what Kenny saw. What'd you see?
I saw a really solid game, much like Kenny did from Maryland, and Rashid Suleiman was the guy who was making it happen. I loved his aggressiveness and hunting for his shots, looking for his offense early. But here he is, moving well without it, no hesitation, rise and let it fly. Then off the dribble, nice little pull up there. He's got the threat to drive, instead backs up and pulls up. And now you see him in transition, early offensive hit. But I like the aggressiveness of his posture and looking for his offense here early. And Maryland played a really strong half and still down by 2.
Yeah, 36-34 in favor of Kansas. Who should feel good about themselves at this point, Chuck?
Kansas, the Maryland guards were fantastic. They really dominate the ball in the half. They control the tempo, but they're down. And if you get everything your way and you're still down, you got to feel good if you're Kansas. Kansas did not play very well. I thought the difference in the game would be Ellis. He has 12. He's playing well. But the Kansas guards, they just can't get overwhelmed. I said, to me, this guard matchup, I thought it would be a wash. Pretty much everything come out in my high-efficiency washer, everything come in together.
Don't get me started. Do not get me started.
I did. I thought it would be a push, but right now Maryland guards have a big lead. I think Kansas guards are going to play better in the second half. But if I'm Kansas, I feel pretty good. Like, we didn't play well. Our guards got really dominated. But we're still up. And you always feel good when you're up in a game.
All right, Kansas by two at the break. Meanwhile, over on TBS, Duke taking on Oregon, the top seed in the West.
And Kobe Bryant in Anaheim checking out the action in a fast-paced, good first 12 minutes or so. That's Elgin Cook driving in for the first hoop for Oregon. And that's him again, tied at four. And that's Dylan Brooks finding Jordan Bell. All Oregon early on, 14-10 after that three by Tyler Dorsey. But right now, Duke has stepped out in front by one, 27-26.
You couldn't get Kobe floor seats?
No. You seen the way he played this year?
He probably chose to sit where he sat. He chose to sit there.
No, not the way the Lakers are playing. He's not getting four seats. No. I'm surprised he's not on the roof. The way the Lakers are playing.
There it is. I was just checking.
You know, I think, Duke has come up with a fantastic game plan. They're not trying to get up in a run and gun situation. Coach Kate's got to, he said, listen, he got to keep these kids on a leash. Because you don't want to get in a run and gun situation with Oregon. It's a nice pace to the game. They're being very patient offensively, getting a good shot every time. They're not letting that press speed them up. Just a great coaching job. But the players are playing well, obviously, also. But you can just tell. He's told them, I'm keeping you kids at the amusement park on a little leash. I want you to play. I want you to play with freedom. But you don't want to rush. You don't want to let Oregon speed you up.
Well, the Duke is now, taking the lead, actually, by 1 point.
You actually said Duke.
Yeah. Oh, excuse me. I read it instead of said it.
But no, I am shocked.
Even more shocking, remember, I thought at the beginning of the game, I said this is sacrilegious, that I'm actually picking him. I think that the two players that they have on the perimeter are unguardable by both. They don't have two players that can guard them. They have one, but every time he moves to the other, I think the other guy, if they move to Ingram, then Allen goes off. If you move to Allen, then Ingram goes off. So you have that wheel. And what Coach K has really done, I think, massively this year is, man, I said something else massively. Oh, my goodness. But what he's done well for me is being able to play more of a pro set with this team, because he's letting those guys open the floor, one floor sets, open the floor, a pick and roll, and allowing them
to play. You can never root for Duke?
I can root for the team playing Duke.
Okay.
We will get Kenny some oxygen, take a little time out.
But they're going to
be back with more AT&T at the half after this.
McClellan gets it to commit, gets the whistle, and the shot drops. Villanova really in control virtually from the start.
They keep getting better, Coach.
Yeah, they do.
Oh, my goodness.
And then there were eight. Win column, Sooners, game over.
Welcome back to AT&T at the half. Earlier tonight, Texas A&M and Oklahoma, the Sooners were the better team.
They certainly were, and team is the right word because Buddy Hield had a pedestrian 17, two of them right there, and then three more right here. But it was Jordan Woodard who led the way. Great save by Spangler. Here comes Woodard. Splash. He had 22, and Isaiah Cousins did not shoot it well, but he led the way with eight assists, one of them right there to Kadeem Latin in Oklahoma. Cruise from late in the first half to the finish line.
They are in their first Elite Eight since 2009, and they will await the winner of Oregon against Duke. Meanwhile, in the South region, in Louisville, Miami and the Villanova Wildcats run fire.
As efficient as any team I've seen in recent years in the tournament in the first three games, 63% shooting because the floor was spaced, the ball was moved, and sometimes you just got to make a deep shot against the shot clock. Chris Jenkins had 21, Oshefu had 17, and it was all Villanova all the time. Wire to wire.
Wildcats led throughout. They will await the winner of Maryland against Kansas. And that is it for us for right now. We thank you for joining us on AT&T at the half. Back to Louisville for the second half of Maryland and Kansas after this.
AT&T at the half is presented by AT&T. mobilizing your world.
During the Lexus Command Performance sales event,
Bruce Johnson steps up to the line.
There's always cause for celebration.
He got it! Did he ever come through with the pressure on?
With extraordinary offers on our most exciting lineup of SUVs ever, including the stylish all-new RX and the dynamic NX.
Turn around, jumper for three.
Because thrills like this only happen during the Command Performance sales event. This is the pursuit of perfection.
NCAA March Madness is here, and it's all on March Madness Live. 68 teams on one quest.
If you want to go to the national championship, it starts today.
The NCAA tournament. What else can you say?
Drama and excitement decided by one shot.
RJ Hunter for three. Goal!
Follow the quest wherever you are, all the way through the championship game.
The kind of moments they talk about for a lifetime.
Watch every game live with March Madness Live, available on Fire tablets.
Tuesday in prime time. Don't miss James Corden's Carpool Karaoke Special with Jennifer Lopez and more. Tuesday at 10, 9 central.
When Americans get in trouble abroad, this team will do anything to save them.
This is a hate crime.
The new hit drama, Criminal Minds Beyond Borders, CBS Wednesday.
Well, the streets are empty on a Friday night in Louisville because the building is packed. We have 20 minutes to go for a spot in the Elite Eight. And we'll return to Louisville after these messages. You're watching the NCAA Men's Basketball Championship.
Coverage of the NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament is sponsored by Subaru. Fruit of the Loom. Coca-Cola. And by the Quicksilver card from Capital One.
Churchill Downs, 6 weeks from Saturday, will host the 142nd running of the Kentucky Derby. Now, what about Mark Turgeon and the Maryland Terrapins? What are their thoughts at halftime? Tracy standing by with the coach.
Coach, just a hard-fought first half between both teams. What do you think will be the difference for your team down the stretch to come away with a win?
Well, transition defense and rebounding. We gave up too many layups and ball screen defense. What, you know, great first half, two teams going at it, two teams playing well defensively. And, you know, maybe a team that gets hot can separate themselves. Neither team's really shooting the ball great, but for us, it's transition defense and ball screen defense.
Thanks a lot. Jim?
Okay, Tracy. You know, this is a program that played six games this year as the second-ranked team in the nation and seven more games as the number three team. Faded late in the year, and this team now looks like it's got a little bit more of a bounce in its step as we saw in the first half.
Yeah, Maryland came out. They came out with a sense of urgency. They played well early on, but they feel like they would be up by 10 points. Kansas still up 2 points after not being sharp there in that first half, Coach.
Well, he mentioned the ball screen, and who did it better than Kansas? I mean, just a solid job. His understanding here, a little screen, slip, and Ellis moves out of the way so intelligently. A little lob, get it into the big fella.
And you know, I love seniors, and Jake Lehman doing it all. Only has 4 points, but four rebounds, three assists, three blocks, two steals, and that was a big one. Who cares if he double dribbles?
As you see, the leading scorers in the first half, this entire first 20 minutes was played within a 9-point window. Maryland's biggest lead was six. Kansas led by three. That was its biggest margin. But Maryland had those weeks near the top of the rankings. Of course, we talk about a Kansas team's played 13 games as the number one team in all the nation and entered the tournament as the overall number one seed. We'll see what Maryland is able to do now as they had to sit a good portion of that first half. Robert Carter, he missed 7 minutes of action. And Diamond Stone only played 11 minutes because they each had foul issues. 2-H. Trimble now has the ball with two fouls of his own.
I mean, Jim, I think being the guard defense here by Kansas, can they contain the dribble penetration? Is Mason healthy? We'll see.
Trimble only been to the line three times. He's got to get to the line at least 12, 13 as Layman misses a running hook shot there.
Yeah, he had the look he wanted. Missed the shot. Is Selvin at the other end. Off the glass high. And now he's got 11. Man,
that was just bully ball right there. Tremendous strength by Selvin.
Mason caused a walk on that pass, and it was not called. He turned to the official. What a heads-up play out of the gate.
The battle of 33s down low. The whistle goes against the one wearing the Kansas jersey, Lucas.
We talked about this matchup, Coach. Selden just using his strength, tremendous touch. Lehman at 6'9", was unable to block that shot, but Selden, he's got to play big here in the second half with Mason struggling.
Second foul on Lucas. There's Trimble going back out with it. That's Carter. Now they hit that three to open the game by Suleiman, then only hit one out of 11 behind the arc after that in the first half. And then they come down and knock down this one for the first minute of the second half by Carter.
And that was Bill Self's biggest concern going into this game, how they played Carter. A little weave as we've seen frequently, a little duck in by Lucas. And he got pushed.
It's gonna be the third on Stone, who saw the Kansas player beat him to the spot.
A good cross
out of position.
I was just thinking the same thing. You got to split the basket when the ball's over there. You just see he's beaten here. He should be leading him in, should be on the top side, and gets pinned and caught. And that gets you in some problems in the seat.
Up to Mason. Quick fire. That's a beauty.
He's too good to stay quiet.
He needed that.
Yeah, he does.
His first three of the night, his second bucket. He's only one out of six in the first half.
And a nice show by Ellis and get back to the spot.
Carter.
Nobody in the post either.
Leave it up outside and not able to connect.
How about that little kick? Yeah, high percentage shooter.
Never felt like Carter was really in full control, but was able to find Dodd and hit the big jumper. And that steal by Suleiman. Two defenders back there. Suleiman makes the move to tie the game at 41.
How about that read?
Yeah.
Defensively, huh?
Great weak side, anticipating getting the steal. Maryland feeling good right now.
Nice give back a little late.
Ellis wants to drive. He's got all those shots around the basket.
Such a tough kid. Great approach. Great presence.
Lehman.
Oh,
they made that one drive and hook shot that failed to go on the first possession of the half. And this time he said, I'm just going to finish it off strong.
He's all legs and arms, gangly. Sort of fits. Great approach and attack. Too easy to get inside.
Ellis somehow squeezes it home past Dodd.
And I tell you, when they need a basket, they go to Mr. Ellis. Mm-hmm. He usually delivers.
And a quick timeout. Oh, Turgeon. I'm not so sure he's happy. Maybe somebody's injured, I think. They're taking him out. How about this attack? Send it in. Number 10, Spider-Man. How about that elevation over the block?
I'll tell you what, and Graham on that play thought about taking a charge and said, let me get out of the way as Lehman attacks the basket.
Had a whistle here. Graham was gimpy, and he's on the bench getting.
He's had this before, I think.
A little help.
He'll be back. This kid's a gamer. Good time performer. Get those liquids in you.
So 8 out of 9 shots combined by these two teams have been made.
Nice curl here.
Start of the second half. Suleiman head fake. Got the pick from Dodd. Now takes off on Lucas. Tough angle.
Good defense by Lucas.
And how about the rebound to check out? That was so sound.
That's on Suleiman on the floor. His first. East meets West in the new action comedy that teams a martial arts master with a wise cracking cop. Rush Hour premieres next Thursday on CBS.
And Raph on that last move, Mason, he looked as good as I've seen him. He turned the corner, had a little burst of energy, hit a three earlier, so maybe he's feeling better. And Selden knocks it down from downtown.
That's the biggest lead of the night now for the Jayhawks at 5.
His numbers are good. He's solid. 4 assists in that first half and making that shot. And that's the one thing Bill Self said. He's going to be super the longer he practices and excels in that area.
Lehman is back out with it. Suleiman right over Selvin, front of the rim.
Numbers here.
Kansas has now hit its last eight shots. Selvin with the three and then the floater. And we've got an injured player for Maryland. It's Suleiman.
And plus the timeout, too. Mark Turner trying to seize the moments. They get organized here, but these, the number, watch how they sprint to the three-point line. You got to cover that and cover that. That's impossible. Little floater.
And it looks like Suleiman might have landed on somebody's leg. It twisted his ankle.
Oh, look at that stretch, too.
Left ankle grimacing in pain.
Yeah. He's ready to come back in, though.
Yeah, he's going
to
check in on the next whistle. He's been taken out for just a flash. He's got to come out because he's stopped play. Kansas on a 7-0 run after the game was tied at 43. And again, it hit the last now. The Jayhawks have hit the last eight from the floor.
Yeah, they got to get something inside, I think. They just settle deep. They're going to hook bigs in there.
Nickens.
Got in tight.
Got a pass, and it's last touch by Mason. And we got the under 16 break. Little flurry here by Kansas. And having now its largest lead of the game.
Greg Dumble in New York with an All-State Good Hands update in Anaheim over on TBS. They have gone to the break. Oregon, the top seed out west. Look at Jordan Bell on the baseline for two. Oregon at halftime leading Duke 36-31. Jim, Raff, Grant, Tracy, back to you.
All right, Greg, the winner to play Oklahoma in the regional final on Saturday. If it's Oregon, Oklahoma, it might look not only like an Elite Eight game, but a college football playoff game. Oregon and Oklahoma. Works out that way. Here's Carter. Graham has re-entered after the cramps. Trimble back to the rim, and it's Lucas.
And it's also Ellis. Presentation there. Caused a tough shot.
Takeaway by Maryland as Stone continues to sit.
Yeah, Carter wanted on the wing. This is the where they like him. Pick and pop. Little pull. Might be Selden on the wing. What do you think?
I thought Graham might have got him on the arm.
It's on Selden on the floor.
And they're going to say shooting.
That's surprising. That's going to be two.
Good call, Coach.
Well, they looked over and saw a former NBA great here and figured continuation.
It's the second miss of the game. Get complete coverage of the NCAA Division I women's tournament at NCAA.com.
Oh boy, Hover's around 90%, 87. He doesn't miss those.
Oh, wow, that one was halfway down to the old 360. Kansas, since a shaky start from the field, 4 out of 18, has hit 68% since. Selvin slips, taken away by Trimble.
Numbers.
Here's Lehman. Pull up three.
Well, that was right there, too.
Couple of empty trips for the Terrapins. As Mason fires and Ellis picks it up. And he's fouled. That free throw that Trimble had is what it looks like with the high-speed cams.
How about that? How does that not stay down? No Cupid doll on that one, huh? Mm. Reminds me of your shots in the Papa Shot contest
last week.
National championship.
Why do you have
Tracy?
To bring up old stuff?
Did you get any feedback during the week about that?
Yeah, you know, I got some feedback.
I know Tracy did.
It wasn't all positive, but Tracy, to her credit, clutch down the stretch, beat me in Papa Shot.
Tchaikovsky is back in. He's seeing minutes again because they're trying to find ways to keep big bodies out there and keep Stone on the bench with the three fouls.
You might say they're trying to leave no stone unturned.
Oh.
I think they need some inside game, though. Points. Chukotsky's got a little offense, low box. And Carter likes to roam outside.
9 unanswered points.
Excuse me, died in there now. Carter taking a blow.
They needed that. Triple.
Big shot.
That's at the 6. Bam. It's around the 7-footer. Here's Seldom. Really going after it. And Tango bodies underneath. And it's going to be on Tchaikovsky.
And you love it when your point guard steps up and makes big plays. Trimble, who's been struggling from the perimeter for a while, but knocks down a timely jump shot for his team.
How long do you think you keep Diamond Stone on the bench?
I think maybe the next timeout, TV timeout.
Under 12.
Yeah, exactly. And terrific defense on the penetration there.
There's Mason to Grant.
Watch out for Lucas, too. He can really duck in and present himself.
Had a switch off for a moment out to Traylor. He's going to try it.
And ooh.
The official. This is going against Kansas. Official almost hit the deck.
Oh, nice control, too, making sure Seldon didn't get hurt.
Lucas down inside, fighting.
Pretty good defense, too, didn't he, the way he rode him out?
Yeah, kind of little elbow, a little push in the back there. The official's right on that.
A little Tavern League discard.
And that's the 3rd on Landon Lucas. And again, cramping up is Graham, who took himself out during that little break. Coach Turgeon's going to bring Nickens back in on the next whistle.
You know, they know he can shoot it. They need somebody. Nice. Pester.
Trimble gave it up at the last moment. Tchaikovsky is fouled.
And a nice play by Trimble with the fine.
Tremendous pass, but I thought Traylor should have just kept his hand straight up, brought his arm down, and brought Tchaikovsky for the foul.
That's the 3rd on Traylor. So Lucas and Traylor, 3 each. Stone with 3 fouls on the Maryland side.
54% free throw shooter.
April 7th through the 10th, beginning 2 weeks from today, we proudly present a tradition unlike any other, the Masters on CBS.
Hey, Jim, did you coin that phrase?
You know, it's been around for a long time. There was a legend at CBS named Doug Tuohy.
Sure.
And also was the same guy that had a big hand in one shining moment.
Oh, wow.
And we miss him. Passed away a few years ago. Great man. Here's Traylor.
Nice cut, but a bad pass. Seldon really trying to take over here. And maybe off him, too. And just left the floor.
Going back to Maryland.
Seldon may be doing a little too much, Coach.
Yeah, I think he's trying to step up a little bit. They're not in sync the way we're accustomed to seeing on that offensive end. And usually it's Mason who gets them coordinated.
But also you have to give some credit here to Maryland. They've come out really well defensively as Graham is back on the bench.
Mason Looney. Hawking, Trimble, nice little screen again. They've run this a couple of times.
Not a good shot.
No, good defense. Mackay looked dangerous on the floor. Dribble drive and a kick.
Mason able to get it out to Traylor. Kansas 3.5 minutes without a field goal.
He loves that drop step. Didn't go.
Almost did. Very important stretch here. Kansas without a bucket for almost 4 minutes, but Maryland not able to capitalize really at the other end.
And Maryland's had some opportunities. They've missed 4 free throws in a row and not being able to close in on this Kansas lead here. But I'd like to see Maryland maybe go back to the high screen and roll with Trimble or even Suleiman. I thought in the first half they did a good job and Kansas was unable to defend that.
Well, Graham's coming in, but even the bigger story on perhaps this night is the presence back on the floor of Diamond Stone, who gives them 13 points a game.
And get him involved in the screen. Let him get to the box. Keep him moving. I think when he just settles on that box, they can't get him to the ball properly.
Stone has only played a minute so far in this half and has 4 points on the game. Again, limited minutes.
They use these post rubs, little duck in. Look at Ellis. Good preparation. So smart. They're trying to get it in.
Superman slashing and hacked and hits the floor.
And he goes to the hole hard, coach.
I love it. You know what? Stone kept people busy. Ellis, he couldn't come over early enough here. Good adjustment. Just comes up a little bit empty, but you are right. Puts it in overdrive.
That's two now on Perry Ellis. Tchaikovsky back in. Stone at 12:08 to go. They're going to go ahead and take him out knowing a defensive trip's coming up. And they got the under 12 break shortly.
You watch Tchaikovsky. He's a skilled player, too. He's going to be terrific next year.
And just a sophomore. Suleiman got them both.
Now you've set a little full court pressure. A little 1-2-2. A little trap on the wings here. Trying to take away the post pass. If anything, make him use some clock, Jim.
Nice look. Over to Ellis. Oh, yes. The balance is always there. The grace. He's got 22, and he's going to the line.
And the play effective because you can use the dribble effectively. Seldon likes to get to the rim, do some damage hard, but the ability to slow it down a little. Draw three. How about that? Ellis, give that guy a jacket. Dress him up.
The Kansas legend, Danny Manning, the all-time scorer in Kansas history. The 1988 most outstanding player at the Final Four. And Perry Ellis now. Last week, he moved into the top 10 on the all-time scoring list at Kansas, moving past Kirk Heinrich. And since now, in these last couple of games, have moved past Dave Robish. And tonight, he's moved past Paul Pierce into eighth all-time. He's having quite a game here tonight. He's 11. He scored 11 of Kansas's 21 second-half points. He's got 23 for the night.
Well, there's some great names up there, but I don't think they had to do as many things as this kid has to do for this team.
It's also the third all-time scorer from the state of Kansas.
Darnell being first, I guess.
Yeah, you know, Danny Manning.
Danny. Well, Danny was Carolina.
Yeah, he played his last 2 years.
He's like you. He has a home here.
Yeah, well, why not? Why not? The more the merrier.
The more the merrier.
Depends on where you are, you know, what you're playing.
And there he is.
Ellis again.
A nice little play.
So efficient.
Oh, and he could have driven to that left side wide open.
Kansas, you talk about adjustments at the halftime, shooting over 70% here in the second half. As Rashid Suleiman loses the ball out of bounds, but just a nice little sort of rip screen or cross screen, and Ellis makes the right read, but where he caught the ball, caught it in his range, 10, 15 feet, knocks it down.
Terps have gone 3.5 without a hoop.
A little mental fatigue, not paying attention to the detail at the other end.
Stone takes it inside. And they wave off the shot.
That's talent right there.
Does that show you something?
Whistles on trailer.
That young man can use either hand around the basket. And there's no continuation here in college, but that move, pretty special.
Fourth on trailer. Terps need a spark. They had that long stretch where Kansas went over 4 minutes without a basket, just a few free throws, and they weren't able to make a dent on the lead. Here's Carter taking it to the hole, and that one does count.
Well, when your bigs can make moves like this, you can do some amazing things. You don't have to load up on the box. A nice little give back here Carter's been settling.
Well, Carter has been traditionally settling, but I love that he attacks the closeout. And Perry Ellis has to try to get out there because of his shooting, and he made a three earlier today.
And that's three on Ellis. That cuts it to eight. Now they got Lucas with three, Ellis with three, Traylor with four. If Maryland's able to keep this game close, who knows? Kansas could have some serious issues. And they're not deep tonight, and missing a significant contributor off the bench in Brandon Green, who's out with a back injury. Suleiman whistled for his second. 1-1 at the line for Mikhailuk. Here's a look at the tournament summary. All four number one seeds made it to the Sweet 16. Got the one seed here in the South. Got the one seed out West in action right now. Oregon leading at the half. And there was Villanova already to the Elite Eight.
And there was all this talk of parity, but the top seeds have advanced thus far.
A lot of excitement, though. A lot of nervous people in some of the outcomes. Keep going to the rim, I think, if you're Maryland. They do some quick hitters. And this is where they toughen up their defense. Self-style.
I like the matchup with Stone, maybe on Bragg.
They can't time it right, though.
Lehman. Mikhailuk got him with the body, and that nearly dropped for Lehman.
A pretty nice choice, though, with the size difference, you know. But they were moving the ball one side. Stone went to the other. A little bit out of sync.
Second on Mikhailuk. So now the young man from the Boston area is actually from right up there near Foxborough, right where the Patriots play. Huge Patriots fan. Lehman, his family, there's a lot of basketball players in the family, including his uncle, Steve McCoy, who played on that Siena team, if you folks remember it, years ago, that was a 14 seed upset of three in Stanford, in the tournament.
I do remember well.
His uncle was on that Siena team.
A great program up there for years. Jimmy Patsos is up there, used to be a assistant coach here at Maryland.
Mike Dean, the old coach there, and they had
that
run.
Time.
Ellis on the bench, 25 points, but sitting with three fouls.
Kansas comes back in with Lucas and Selden to give a little bit of size and physicality inside for Kansas.
And Graham, too, as he goes to the rim, doesn't get the call. Graham not as spry either with the look at this help and a giveaway.
And Trimble is called for his third.
And Bill wants a flagrant one on that particular play. They don't call it intentional anymore, but this is just stopping a basket.
And it looked like Trimble might have slipped as he was trying to turn the corner and might have slipped a little bit and lost the ball, which is not something he commonly does. But I like the fact that he's still attacking and Maryland trying to get into the paint, draw fouls on Kansas.
And that's the first turnover of this half for Maryland. Puts Mason on the line. And just double checking. We hear who the foul is called on.
No player control foul.
Player control, they say now. Okay.
Interesting. Well, Mason, look at Graham rubbing his calves right at half court in front of us. He is really hurting.
So not going to be a shooting situation. Kansas will inbound at the far end.
You ought to try some of that Midwest charm that Bill Self has, you know. See how nice he was to the officials?
So nice. You got the, you know, there's a reason, I guess, for his success. Maybe I will try to incorporate that.
You got it.
Only you, Raph, could say that to the nicest guy in the world.
Yeah, yeah, the truth.
With that sense of humor.
That was a peculiar play. I thought he had the ball and was going, didn't you?
I did too.
Nice.
Selden. He's looked good in this half. That one's tapped out.
Nice save.
Graham tries to throw it off the Maryland player and misses.
Well, we've seen that play a few times, right? Northern Iowa trying to inbound.
Okay, Maryland's already had one possession. Coming down the floor, down seven, trying to chip away. They're going to bring Trimble back in. He's set out for just a few seconds.
Well, I'd like to see Maryland give the big fella Stone some touches down inside. Or if not, keep driving, attacking the basket, getting to the free throw line.
Get that number 33 down on the block.
They got the first five out there. That's not been the case for all that much tonight.
And dribble drive or a post up, nice little double screen. Here it is. This is where he gets right to the rim now, Stone.
Triple, huge shot, three is short.
Nice check out.
Yeah, Mason boxed out. Yeah. Trimble wouldn't allow him to retrieve it.
Little things mean so much.
Also a great closeout by Mason, helping inside but getting out, contesting that jump shot.
It's Dodd for Carter.
Well, they really haven't been able to get anything out of this pressure here.
Nickens on the court as well as Trimble. It's a little extra time added to a break before the under eight.
Just checked in the game.
Yeah, Nickens can make a shot. That's one thing. Of course, that length in this press is what they were looking for.
Selden.
What a match here, I think. Give it back to him. I think Selden can do some damage.
Yeah, he wants it. He wants it, and it slides off the back of the rim.
See if he can get a drag screen here in transition.
Suleiman lost it on the way in. Stone wants it. Pretty. Left hand, no. Dodd is fighting for it. Lucas on the floor. Travel.
Yeah, went down. Once you're standing up and go to the floor, Stone right at the rim. Heartbreak. Oh, that little left, and he's good at it. You mentioned early, either hand. This is aggressive Lucas pursuit.
They check back in, Carter and Trimble. At the 8:07 mark.
Coach, I like it when Maryland gets in this high screening roll, allowing the guards to turn the corner. Mm-hmm. See if they bring Stone up.
This time Carter, he can step out and make that deep jumper. Look at the cover, and they get it to him a little too late.
It's Carter taking on Ellis. Gave it up to Stone, and it's taken out of there by Selden.
Too close, maybe, to quarters. Watch for Ellis at the end of this. Always busy.
To Lucas.
Yeah, it's right around the corner. They do a nice job. That kid knows how to play. Big, broad shoulders. Footwork. Maryland. Pretty good combo.
Sure, Jim. Sorry. They had three straight empty trips trying to cut into a 7-point deficit. And then Kansas able to score at the other end. And that's on Stone. His fourth.
Now the big guy just didn't recognize the distance and balance. Now they got to step it up, Jim. They're going to get back in this, Maryland. Their offense has been a little sketchy defensively, hurting with the guards of Kansas.
That was a big call, the fourth on Stone. Had it gone the other way, it would have been the fourth on Lucas.
And Coach, you talked about the little things. Lucas, the presence of mind to take the contact and draw the foul.
Stone, I think it's legit too, don't you?
I do. I think it is. Stone dropped his shoulder against Lucas, and now he's sitting on the bench for four.
And that could have been trouble for Lucas, right, Jim?
It would have been his fourth.
Yeah.
Tough.
He does that nicely.
That's Lucas.
Just a little bit here and there. Keeps it together, Lucas.
Mason ran out of room, and that was because he was hit with the body by Tchaikovsky. Let's check in with Tracy.
Jim, that Maryland huddle was all Suleiman talking to his team, the leader, trying to get his team to believe. He said, we still have 7 minutes left to play. Play for each other. Play hard. Be confident. Suleiman hoping to get his team going down the stretch here, Jim.
Trying to do everything he can to extend his college career.
That's what he's brought to this team, leadership. Suleiman himself, freshman year, had an Elite Eight run at Duke. So he has that postseason experience and trying to implore his team to show some life and fight back in this game.
It could start if they got that rebound. I mean, they're going to do a better job. It's action that counts now coming down the stretch. Get something going to the rim. Get a little life.
11 points ties the largest lead of the game.
Look at this gang defense. It's always Ellis in the middle.
He walked on that one.
He got away with it. Well, look at Ellis.
Look at Ellis.
Show, and now he's going to get back, and no jump shot. Look at this. It's beautiful.
Carter drives. Last touch by Kansas with five to shoot.
Talk about expending energy. Just wonderful how he's able to show, recover, get back in position. Just terrific.
What kind of shot can Maryland get off here? It's Carter. And Lucas with the box out. He's a good rebounder. Yeah.
I like putting the decision in a referee's hand a little more. Instead of settling outside, just need two. Need something going towards the rim.
Ninth rebound of the game for Lucas as Ellis
hits another shot. And we saw that very same play earlier. When things are kind of in doubt, you go to Mr. Ellis.
And that's just not Dodd's defensive position to come out and play a guy who's great off the dribble. Quality performer, Ellis. Ringing a bell, some nylon. What a performance.
For parents of boys and girls ages 7 to 15, regardless of skill level, Drive Chip and Putt registration is open. Visit drivechipandputt.com. Find a local qualifier and register. The winners plus a parent advance to the 2017 National Finals at Augusta National.
PGA just sent out a flyer. A young lady by the name of Leo Hill took her dad.
Yes. Whew. I've seen the video. You've got to put her in the Drive, Chip, and Putt next year, Grant, for this year.
I'll tell you, after she beat me, I think I will.
Wave off the basket. The foul is on the floor. Kansas' last loss back in the third week of January in Ames, Iowa. And since that time, this is what they've done.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they don't beat you. They beat you badly. And they just take it to you. I like the call here, getting to the rim. More of that to sneak back in it.
And since that loss, they've inserted Lucas to the lineup. And mm-hmm. has just made a huge difference. His presence, the little things as you talk about, rebounding defense, accepting his role and embracing it.
So Romello, Delonte, Trimble hits two, and they're going to pick it up full court. Grant has it taken away by Lehman, but he was on the line.
A little more of that. He's so big and such a great presence on the ball. The wingspan is amazing, you know, even on the trap, but even on the inbound. Good call right there. He knows, couldn't get control of it.
And Coach, how many times have we seen during this tournament teams struggle with leads going against the pressure mm-hmm. of a press?
Now it's that time of year right now.
It's that time of year
to advance.
The officials adjusted the shot clock since it wasn't a full change of possession. 27.
Nice job posting. You saw Sullivan run through the middle, opens it up for Graham.
We talked earlier about Maryland going small. Now they have Lehman playing the power four position, matched up on Perry Ellis, trying to bring some hustle on the defensive end.
Ooh, they're going to get Carter on that little wrap around. Just got there a little bit late. Yeah, I don't think that's a bad idea because of that length. Lehman playing Ellis.
And he's accustomed to that. He's played some stretch four last season when they didn't have the presence of Diamond Stone and Robert Carter.
That's the third on Carter. Two shots and gives him 9 and 9. It's country music's party of the year with your host, Luke Bryan, Dierks Bentley. Don't miss all your favorite stars. The ACM Awards live Sunday, April 3rd, only CBS.
Nice little pinch post entry started that.
Fortunate bounce that time, and the lead back to 13. Maryland in the midst of a third long field goal drought of this half.
Oh, great defense again.
Mason, and it's tapped out. Seldon with Trimble trying to defend. Seldon's going to get whistled for it.
And I like Trimble fighting to the end. Griselda was going to try and bring the house down in front of the field there. Just the rotation here is terrific.
Great rotation. Help the helper. Multiple efforts on defense, creating the turnover. And this man right here is like a freight train in transition.
Yeah. He is something at that rim, too.
And here's the push by Trimble, his fourth.
It shows you the strength, how he got discarded.
But on the offensive end, I'd like to see Maryland run screen and roll with Lucas's man setting the screen and roll. Perry Ellis, as you showed earlier, has done just a tremendous job of helping and getting back.
Good point.
Nothing to hold him back for any longer. Diamond Stone is back on the floor. He has four. Trimble has four. And it's desperate times now for Maryland.
Lucas. Will Ellis get it? Yes, he does. Bud Lehman says, get that out of here.
How about that response? The spider in the open floor.
I'm sorry for hitting you, coach.
Oh, that's all right. You got excited. I don't blame you. A terrific look. Ellis thinks he's going to really punch this one home. And what a reaction.
Wow.
Beautiful effort. Leaving it all out.
And I love the pass, but boy, Lehman was ready for his fourth block. Four of the six for the Terps.
He's so flexible. Now he's on Graham on the far side. Goal screen, empty side.
Sylvan. And that's Stone who risked it all. He blocked it.
There's some great defense on both ends. Confrontations at the rim.
Just right there, Ellis withstanding Suleiman's approach.
6 minutes without a basket for the Terrapins.
This kid can guard anybody. You want to run the floor, Jim?
The drought continues.
Maryland came out in the first half as Mason down the lane with the easy finish.
And right away you saw the heads of Maryland go down. And nobody stopped that dribble drive.
Timeout, Maryland. Kansas has opened it up. Maryland hasn't been able to find a shot now for a long time. They had all those trips trying to cut into a 7-point deficit, and now suddenly it's 16 for Kansas. Here's the lineup tomorrow. Sweet 16 action continues on CBS and TBS. It begins with the Infinity Tip-Off Show at 6 Eastern on TBS. Look who's here. One of the three greatest athletes ever from the city of Louisville, the great Paul Hornung, who won the Heisman Trophy 60 years ago, 1956 at Notre Dame.
Wow.
He told me earlier today, almost went to Kentucky. Paul Bear Bryant was the coach then, and he wanted to play basketball for Adolph Rupp. And he asked Bear to see if he could double up. And there's a much-needed three by Maryland. Bear talked to Rupp. Rupp said, you know what, you try out, you're good enough, you'll be on the team. He didn't get the guarantee, and he went to Notre Dame.
I guess Rupp had plenty of time, and that's the counter to the press. I did his radio show years ago. What a fun night.
I can only imagine.
You two together, look out. Close down the city.
I was the copper boy.
Yeah, sure. They actually played college basketball his senior year at Notre Dame, didn't they? Here's Nickens trying another long one.
And that's his game. Ooh, a little push up, 33 on 33.
Yeah, that'll be the fourth on Lucas.
We like his game, right?
Yes, we do. But it helps attacking the press when you have guys like Sylvan who can make these kind of passes. Lucas just doing a little bit of everything tonight. Rebounding, defending, dunking, playing big for the Jayhawks.
Well, I think Sylvan's really proven himself this evening, too. What's that, 7 assists?
Stone will get one more. I mentioned, by the way, that Hornung, one of three arguably greatest athletes, and there's no argument about Hornung, no argument about Muhammad Ali, and I'd say no argument about Phil Simms.
Oh, that's
raised right here in Louisville. Went on to win, of course, Super Bowl MVP, a couple of Super Bowls for the Giants.
Your colleague.
My colleague, I proudly say.
And his boys were pretty good basketball players, too. Did he play any basketball for? That's the game's too fast for him. He's strictly a drop back, you know. Give me protection or plenty.
If he played, he was a spot-up shooter.
But he can play golf, as we all know.
Sure. Sylvan gets past Nickens, who then reaches in. 2:50 to go. The margin's 14.
This attack at the rim, they got the, oh, they have a T.
Double technical there, a little
woofing.
A little chippy.
Unnecessary. Vern Harris trying to stem the tide.
Tell you what, though, on that last play that Seldon drove to the basket, got hit hard, and just most people would fall, but he's so strong.
He is solid. You're right.
I saw that shot of Coach Turgeon. Can you imagine what it's like for him? So tied to Kansas, you know, growing up in the state and in Topeka. The first Jayhawk to ever participate in four NCAA tournaments. Mm-hmm. Point guard on a Final Four team in 86. Then spends all those years after he graduates in 87 on the bench, you know, including the 88 title team.
Wasn't Bill on the bench, too?
Yes, he was. Yeah. They were there at the same time.
Who else was there? John Calipari.
Oh, of course.
Oh, right?
Wow. God.
Amazing.
What a staff.
You know, Larry Brown, you know, everybody who played for Larry Brown. I did the Nets games for years, and everybody there, and I've heard Mike Jawinski say on our air, you know, end of a game, decisions he would make on the fly were incredible. Everybody who played for him, he was imaginative, he still is.
Triple. Trying to work off the pick of Stone. Nickens launches.
Everybody helps. Mason, smallest guy on the floor. We'll tell you, if he gets his game back and he's healthy, they are going to be very difficult on Saturday evening.
I'll tell you, the story has been the defense here of Kansas in the second half, holding Maryland to 25 points.
There's his move. He loves that baby.
He does.
Drop step, come back to that left shoulder.
We didn't see it much today.
No, that was the first time. Yeah.
Triple goes back out to Suleiman. Over Graham, short.
And you know these Kansas challenges. You don't get open shots.
Second half, Maryland has shot under 33%. Kansas defense has been great, Coach.
And the Jayhawk contingent here on its feet. Ready to see this one close out and start setting sights on Villanova, that matchup on Saturday night. Ellis. He's already tied a season high tonight with 27. Basket will not count.
Looked like Trimble got fouled twice.
After all the games are over, tune in to TBS for Inside March Madness, presented by Buick.
And Jim, not that it's a factor. This team had a fly back on Monday, Maryland.
Yeah, they played in Spokane the first weekend. Yeah, had the Sunday night game out there. And elected not to red eye, which was smart. Mm-hmm.
I don't think it would have mattered the way Kansas played.
Right.
You know, it's just tough on young people going cross country.
Trimble with 17 now. Suleiman 16 for Maryland.
This is Mason, and he flies down the floor.
Well, Mark Turgeon used to coach at Texas A&M, and there's a lob, man, off the fingertips of Lucas. Put back, yes.
How about that?
I was thinking maybe he left the comeback playbook behind that was utilized against you and I.
Well, he had his troubles with Kansas when he was at A&M.
We faced him six or seven times.
Over six, I think.
Never beat him.
Yeah. Well prepared, this team.
Suleiman at two more. And a timeout.
I think he's going to get some people in, give him a chance to be in the NCAA. Why not?
Coming out of a Maryland timeout, less than a minute to go here, just 47 seconds. The game was tied early stages of the second half at 43. And then Kansas went on a 9-point run and has been in control ever since. Maryland's had stretches where it just could not get a basket to drop.
And some free throws, a little run there. Just four, I believe, Grant was saying.
Got to give Mark Turgeon some credit for bringing this program back and making them relevant.
Mm-hmm. Sweet 16 for the program for the first time since 2003.
That's a chant you don't want to hear if you're a visiting student.
Man, with two to shoot, Selden comes right back to Ellis, and they can just run it out now, and Maryland will oblige.
Ball didn't hit the rim, Coach.
Yeah, it didn't.
Well,
wouldn't matter at this point, I guess, right?
You work it down. Actually, Mason made the shot. Made the shot, and official looked over, thumbs up, it should count.
Yeah, you're right.
He just flipped it up at one end. Well, you play all these games, you have all this craziness happen in the first round of the tournament. And look what you have now. You have the 1 and the 2 in a regional final. Oregon's leading out west. That's still got time to play, so that's not a final. I'm not going to give them a win yet, but if they do win, that'll be the 1 and the 2 in the West.
It's amazing how it always comes down to that, though. The excitement of the first weekend, and I guess class starts to tell or prevail.
Exactly, and this year in particular, with all the upsets, particularly the first week, now you see two regional finals, number one, number two.
They're trying to determine, actually, the officials are over checking the replay, whether the last basket counts.
I don't think this is a rub-in basket. I think it's just a fool-around thing.
It looked good to me.
And the officials left. I thought it was traveling, actually. Just bring everybody out and play the last second.
I wonder if Paul Horning hung around for that last play.
He might have been interested. Yeah, they're still working on this one. They're still trying to determine whether it's a 79-63 final or 77-63. They are going through. I mean, I've never seen any set of officials grind over so many replays over something that's so inconsequential.
They are very detail oriented here today. Man.
Now here's the travel, right?
Oh,
okay, bring it back out, 1.4. Somebody go get the refs out of the shower and let's know what they thought. Now, there's one official over there checking it out.
He obviously doesn't have dinner reservations.
All right, Tracy, in the meantime, over to you.
Yeah, I'm with the star, Perry Ellis, and you just made it look so easy out there. Was there a point in the game where you just said, it's time for me to take over?
From the first half, I just wanted to go attack, you know. That's all my coaches and my teammates tell me to do, just go attack and keep going, and that's what I did.
You just had some words with your coach. First, he asked you if you're tired. You're not tired, are you?
Just a little bit, you know, but just get some fluids and I'll be all right.
What did he say to you, though, after that?
He said he was so proud of me, how I went out there and attacked, and just happy for the win.
How does the Elite Eight sound to you?
Sounds great. I just want to try to keep going. We just want to keep playing and keep having fun.
Good luck. Thanks a lot. Congratulations. Jim?
I have news to report. This is the closest thing we've had to a buzzer beater for our crew.
The basket counts! Great news!
Yes. Oh, that felt good to be able to say that. Get one down to the wire. 79-63. Kansas and Villanova here Saturday night. We'll see you then. Our studio coming up after these messages.
Drip, drip, drop.
Dropping dimes, dropping dimes.
Baby Dame Dollar here, trailblazing dimes everywhere. I don't want to boast, but I'm dropping dimes from coast to coast. Dropping dimes everywhere, like I just don't care. I'm dropping dimes on the bike, on the stairs. I'm even dropping dimes on my teddy bear.
I probably shouldn't have brought up how much money you can save with State Farm by combining your home and auto insurance around the kids.
Kevin, where do you get all them dimes from?
Combine home and auto. Save money. Drop dimes.
That's another from three-point land. What an incredible shot right there.
Alexa, ask Domino's for my easy order.
Ordering Domino's.
Smitty, you haven't moved. Alexa, ask Fitbit how many steps I've taken today.
You have taken 7 steps.
She riles down.
Welcome back to the world to the Final Four. Kansas over Maryland by a score of 79-63 to advance to the Elite Eight. The Jayhawks will play Villanova on Saturday. Welcome back, everyone. Greg Gumbel in New York with the usual suspects, Clark, Kenny, and Chuck. Let's talk about the matchup now. Villanova going up against Kansas, two teams that are playing really, really well, Chuck.
Well, rock, chalk, chalk, talk. Well, listen, I can't say anything about bad about Villanova because my daughter would kill me. That's going to be a heck of a game. The way Villanova is shooting the ball, but Kansas has the ability. I love their depth. I love they don't panic. When they got down tonight, they did not panic. They were just methodical. I'm going to have to go.
Sleep on it.
I'm going to have to sleep on it.
We know what side of the bed you're sleeping on, without saying it. I know
you're sleeping on,
he's sleeping on that Kansas side of the bed. You know, just an overall impressive win. They were able to shut down the perimeter. What gave them the mark of a great team is what sometimes what gives you problems becomes your strength. And that's what I thought, Clark, they saw in the second half. Mm-hmm. The pick and roll gave them problems in the first half. The second half, it was their strength on the defensive end. Great job by Kansas.
I like what Villanova's done. They've been able to execute their offense defensively. They've been excellent. I like Kansas just by a whisker because of Perry Ellis and his ability to score various ways on the front line. And the backcourt is good enough. It's as good as it has to be, it seems, when you look at Frank Mason III, Devontae Graham, not really good in the first half, ramped it up. And I think they'll find a way to be good enough against a terrific Villanova team. So I've had Kansas going to the Final Four since the tournament bracket came out, and I'm going to stay with
All right, guys, right now, Sweet 16 is continuing with Duke and Oregon over on TBS, and that game now has 3:28 to play in the second half, and Oregon in charge, 74-61 over Duke. So Oregon, another top seed, looks like they are well on their way. I want to remind you tonight, after your late news, don't miss The Late Show with Stephen Colbert as he welcomes Olivia Munn, followed by The Late Late Show with James Corden, only CBS. We remind you, too, coming up tomorrow night, the Sweet 16 wraps up. Take a look at the games coming your way. Iowa State, Virginia, Wisconsin, Notre Dame, Gonzaga, Syracuse, Indiana against the top-seeded Carolina Tar Heels. Kenny will probably show up for that.
You know what side of the bed I'm sleeping on?
Come on, Indiana.
Watching the road to the Final Four, everyone. For Clark, for Kenny, for Charles, I'm Greg. Good night.
Come on, Indiana. I've been waiting for this moment. It's good to be alive right about now.